Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do a 22-week pregnancy update for you guys. Today I am 22 weeks and 6 days, so our little guy is the size of a spaghetti squash. He is definitely getting big in there. I can feel him kicking and I can actually see it on the outside of my tummy now, so that's really exciting. His movement is very noticeable now. I can actually see it on the outside of my belly and feel it, and Ethan can also feel it as well whenever he puts his hand on my belly. Whenever he is very active, he moves around all day pretty much. I mean, there are hours where he is probably sleeping, so he's not moving around a lot, but at night he tends to want to kick, and especially when I switch over on my sides. Symptoms that I've been having is that I've had really, really dry skin. I don't know if this is because we moved to a whole new like area and it's a lot colder up here and drier, but I do believe that some of it has to do with the pregnancy as well, because it has never been this dry before. I put lotion on, I have used cocoa butter, I have used baby oil, and I don't know, I just need to find something that can help me battle this dry skin, because it is that bad. Like, yeah, it's all over. It's not just in the belly and the hands, it's all over my body. I just feel so dry and it's very uncomfortable, and it's definitely something that I need to get figured out, because I'm going to be pregnant all winter, and it's not going to get warm up here until around March or so. So if that, I don't know how it is in Massachusetts. Some other symptoms I've been having is that I've just had a really dry throat and nose. Some of it I do think is from the steam radiators that we use to heat our apartment, but I also feel that it does have something to do with the pregnancy as well. So I've been using a humidifier and I have felt a lot better now. I'm not as stuffed up and I wasn't really sick. I didn't really have a cold per se. It was just dry nasal passages and having to walk outside in the cold. My cravings, I don't really have any specific cravings or things that I want to eat all the time. I do enjoy bagels with strawberry cream cheese. I was never a fan of cream cheese at all on my bagels until this pregnancy. I had one and then I was hooked. Not a lot, but maybe one in the morning when I get up. Pregnancy has been going well. I haven't had any flare-ups with the polyomyelitis cyst that I mentioned in my last pregnancy update, so that's good. So something I have been loving in my pregnancy so far are these pregnancy dopplers. It is from Angel Sounds. I ordered it on Amazon, and this is the first one that I got. It works pretty well. You just put a little oil on it. Just use this little part on the back to your baby. And there's also two headset jack so that you and your partner can listen to the baby's heartbeat at the same time. But I couldn't get the speaker to play. Maybe it's just a speaker that I have, or the auxiliary cord that I have, to play this out loud. So I was unable to actually listen to it through a speaker. So that was the only downside of this Doppler for me. I paid maybe like $30 for it on Amazon. Yeah, that's something that, looking for a Doppler for Amazon, something cheap. This is a great little pocket Doppler one here. And then this one I got as a gift from a friend that sent me like a little package. Pregnancy yoga pants and the What to Expect book. I've actually received two copies of that book so far, and I haven't yet to read it. But yeah, this is an awesome Doppler. I do love it because it does have the speaker here and also the headset jack at the top. It works so well. I will show you guys in a second his heartbeat, but this is an amazing, I'm not sure where she got it at. I think maybe Walmart, because when I was looking for a pregnancy Doppler, I do believe that I stumbled across this on the Walmart website. And yeah, so if you are looking for a Doppler, something that plays out loud so you don't have to rely on headsets, this one's awesome as well. I can't tell you where I got it from, but I am grateful that I do have a Doppler, because it's just made me feel a lot more ease throughout this pregnancy because I've been able to hear my baby's heartbeat and not just have to rely on the doctor's appointments or like hope for his movement in my belly. And yeah, so this is really great. At 22 weeks, nothing has really changed for me. I am just getting bigger and I am so excited about that. I love to see him grow. I have had some pains in my belly, just growing pains, obviously, because the uterus is expanding and the baby, he is getting very big in there. So I have to say he has to weigh a pound by now for sure, because I can feel it on my back. I can't imagine what it's gonna be like. I still have like 18 weeks to go. He's just gonna get bigger from here, and I'm just so grateful that the pregnancy has been well so far. I have another doctor's appointment on January 19th. I recently had one just to take my blood pressure out. It was normal, and so I'm grateful for that. I haven't had any signs of preeclampsia so far, even though they thought that I did. At 21 weeks, it was during the closing of the show, I had some pain in my tummy and my back. My uterus felt really tight, my back felt really tight, and it was because I hadn't drank enough water that day before I started doing my physical activities. So that day I had drank a glass of milk and I had had a soda, because the day before that all I've been drinking is so much water, just trying to keep myself hydrated and keep the baby hydrated. And I still drink a lot of water, but obviously I want to treat myself sometimes. A soda every once in a while, it's not gonna hurt the baby as long as I'm not drinking it every day. And I don't really drink coffee either, so the caffeine I've definitely pretty much cut from my diet. And I try to avoid high fructose corn syrup, but I had only drank maybe like half a bottle of water, and I had felt really, really just tight and sore in my back, in my tummy. I've never felt that pain before, and I called the nurse, and she said they had me go in and take a little sample to see if I had a UTI, which thankfully I did not, because I do not want to take any more antibiotics. I've taken so much of those since this pregnancy, and two times I've had to take the antibiotics. And then just getting a really bad yeast infection, which I'm sure a lot of women experience that when they take antibiotics. I just don't feel good to be taking medication, especially when I have a little baby inside. So I am so thankful that I did not have a UTI that was causing it. And since then, I haven't really had any pains like that. Like I said, just the growing pains, which are normal. She told me to up my water intake to 54 fluid ounces a day, so I've definitely been doing that, and I haven't been drinking as much juice or sweet things. So yeah, I'm definitely making sure that I keep my water intake up, because I want to make sure that my baby's healthy and that he's hydrated and that he stays that way throughout the whole pregnancy until he's here on this earth. And yeah, so I will show you guys a book update. So this is my belly at 22 weeks and 6 days. I feel like it's a little pointy and weird looking. It's an every belly. My belly button is definitely starting to look. There's his heartbeat. If you can hear that, my neighbor is vacuuming, so. But yeah, that was his heartbeat. Like I said, doctors are awesome to hear and listen and be able to hear your baby whenever you feel like it. And so I am very grateful that I did buy one of those. I know some doctors are even that you don't, so you're not like stressing yourself out if you can't find the heartbeat or anything, but I am glad that I did make the purchase to get one of those Dopplers, because it is just an amazing feeling to just pull it out and just be able to hear him and make sure that he's doing well. So before I close out the video, I just want to mention one more symptom that I've been having. I have had so much hair on my belly. I've always had like a little happy trail, but it has gotten so thick since the baby. And I've also noticed that line that pregnant women get right from their belly button down, I have noticed that. So thank you guys for tuning in to my 22 week pregnancy update. I will do another one at 24 weeks, and I thank you guys for checking out my videos, and I hope you guys will subscribe and follow us on this journey. Just check out my other videos as well. I just thank you guys so much for tuning in, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. See you soon. Bye.